in a hole in the ground. There lived a hobbit.
Wait, I'm not a hobbit.
Hello everyone, how are you all doing? My name is Lock Rules and welcome to another build tutorial video. Today we're going to be designing a hobbit hole. So let's just get started. Let's have a look around some of the hobbit holes that some of the build team has made already. And just jump inside of one. This one was furnished and designed by the lovely Pythonor. I'm sure he won't mind me showing off his design. If we just have a quick look around and see what he's done inside of here. Okay, and let's make sure we shut the door. We don't want to let a draft in. So that's the sort of thing we're going to be making. That's the sort of thing we're going to be designing. And if we just fly over to the corner here, we have a perfect area to design a hobbit hole. It'll be criminal not to use this area as it's perfect for a hobbit hole. So let's just go inside and let's get started designing the hobbit hole. We can have an entrance and one or two windows. We've got enough room. You can make a garden. It's going to be a perfect area. So we're just going to jump down and get started. So we're going to need to get rid of the dirt here, purely because we want a flat surface to work on to make all the windows. So just get rid of all the dirt, and thinking about it would probably be easier to use world editor here. So just get rid of all of this. That will save a lot of time. I do appreciate it. Some people don't use world edit, some people aren't using older versions of Minecraft, so you might not be able to do something like that. But it just saves time for the video. And we can sort of map out how we want it to look. So we want maybe a window here. And we're going to need to try and get some spruce stairs. We can have a window there and it can end there. And then we can have the entrance. Entrance can be about here. And we'll design it with some sandstone stairs. And we can have that sort of coming inward slightly. And that can come in like that, and then that can be the doorway. And then we want to design the same thing over here. And the stair... Nope, wrong place. There we go. And then that can be the entrance. And then we can have another window around about here. Sort of design where we want the window to be. So we've got a bit of a gap. That should look okay. And then... No, we'll move it along a bit further. Have it there instead. And then we can design the window. And then the window can actually be there. And then another spruce. Actually, no, that's probably going to be too far along. We don't really want that extending. Actually, thinking about it, that should be fine, actually. That should work out absolutely fine. Okay, so we've got one window there. We'll probably need to cover it up a little bit though. Just build it up. Roughly how we're going to want it. And then we have some logs coming across here. And we just want to build up the side of the hill here now. Now we've destroyed it. We just want to build it back and just build it around to make it look natural. Just fly over here. Just cover this. Cover this side. Cover down here. Cover the top. Cover the side there, build it along, build over here, and we'll just place some template here because chances are we're going to change that later on. And that's just a rough idea of how we're going to be having this. I'm just going to reduce my speed, I seem to be flying way too quickly, it's making it difficult. So I'm just trying to think now how I want to design the top. I'm just using spruce wood. I know I'm using slabs, don't judge me. I just find it easier for whatever reason. So I'm trying to think how I want to make the front of the hobbit hole. I'm trying to design the front while I'm just trying to think about it in my head. As I say in every single one of these tutorial videos, I don't really plan anything. I just sort of wing it and do it how I go along and just change things about how I think they look and how I want to make changes. So yeah, this bit here really defines the colour of the hobbit hole. I'm going to be using yellow, but you can change the colour, make it whatever colour you see fit. And yeah, I'm just trying to do the top, try and finish that off, and try to make this look natural. I'm going to get rid of these bits here now after spending all that effort placing them. And I'm going to, I don't know, maybe I can alternate, like so. And that will be okay. Just fill that in there. Just build that up. Get rid of that. Oh, there we go. And then we can have the window. Have this being a window here. So we could possibly put some grass there. Maybe have a flower there later on. And then we'll use sandstone round here to make the window. And there we go. We'll change that round. Use them instead. That works. And that's kind of the entrance and the side window. Just cover this round a little bit. Make it a little bit more, I don't know, surrounded by dirt. Make it look like it's actually built into the side of the hill rather than rebuilt. I guess we did build it into the side of the hill, but we kind of got rid of it and welded it. It look a bit bland at the moment. We can probably get some leaves and put some leaves around to make some sort of shrubbery, some overgrown. Just place a few of them around. Place them over here. Like that. We probably need a bit more than that, to be honest. Maybe some at the top. Okay, that'll do for the time being. I might add a bit more later on. Trying to think what else we can do. Because at the moment this doesn't look particularly right. Maybe we have this bit more over here. Build this up a little bit. Have that into the side and then build that round. What do you guys think? It's just looking a bit square, that's all I'm thinking right now. Trying to think of a way to make this seem a bit more rounded. If we get rid of that, get rid of that one. Maybe if I make these into corner pieces. It looks a bit better. I don't know if it's perfect, but we'll probably make a couple changes later on. But that's all for the time being. We can probably do a bit of a garden now. That can make it a bit more lively if we just add a bit of a garden to our hobbit hole. So we're going to need some fences, the rock tab. And then we might also want some, I don't know, some wood. Might use some of that. And let's use some stairs as well. If we make a bench or something like that. And that'll do. We'll just make a bit of a garden. So we'll just have this coming around here. And have it along here. And this would be the entrance, and then we have it going down here. Okay, have that a bit further along. That'll do. And then we can make a bit of a bench over here, so somewhere to sit and for our hobbit to smoke all of his pipe weed. So we can sit on the bench like so and wait for Gandalf to come along. And we can possibly make a bit of a garden as well. So we're going to want to get some pumpkins and melons. Where are they? I'll just search it. Pumpkin. And we'll get some watermelon as well. Oh no, it's called melon, not watermelon. And let's also make a bit of a garden as well. So we'll use some dirt. We'll need some seeds. We need to hoe. Let's just get some seeds. And let's use pumpkin and melon seeds. Okay. Okay. So let's make a bit of a garden. We could use normal seeds and make wheat. That could also look quite good, but purely because I've got so many wheat farms already, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to use a pumpkin and melon. Did I just get rid of the hoe? Oh, I'm an idiot. Okay, try and find that again. And then create some farmland and place a few pumpkin seeds. That going along there. Wrong one. And over here we can have some melon. So place a couple of melons down. And then farm that out. Place some melon. What else could we do? Let's go put a couple flowers down. We'll just use the same one. Rather than putting bone meal or something, we'll just have a couple of the same flower to make a flower bed. Put that there. Let There we go. That'll do for the time being. We can make a couple of changes after, but I think we're making progress. You just come inside and let's work on the actual hull of the Hobbit hole. I mean, a Hobbit hole is actually mainly interior. There isn't much exterior involved. With a Hobbit hole, you're mainly focusing on doing good interior as opposed to the exterior. And I'm just trying to find where I have the window. I'm just getting a bit dark. I want to get a torch. If you can find it. And we'll just place the torch on the floor. And let's try and find the window. There we go. And we just want that to join up. So we just find that. And let's try and use weld at it. Oh. There we go. I'm using the wrong tool, aren't I? I just need to... Okay, there we go. First position, and then let's just fly over here. And let's dig out this bit here. So just find where we want it to go. Dig. Light it up again with another torch. It's getting a bit dark. I know you guys on YouTube won't be able to see what the hell I'm doing. Oh, oops. Oh, God. Okay. So, first position. I'm going to need to do it again because I just use... I'm an idiot. Okay, fly over here, and first position, and then set zero, and there we go. That's going to be our area that we're going to build in. Just going to light it up, and this is going to be the Hobbit hole. So we're just going to want to make wood over here, and then we'll just use, do you want that wood? Let's try it out with a different colour. Not sure. I'm just going to use a normal wood. That'll do. Okay, and... just put that in there like so. Get rid of that. Get rid of that bit there. Dig all of that out. And then we can just design a couple of the rooms as well. So this is going to be the entrance. I'll put a roof on as well. We need a roof. Set wood. There we go. And let's work on the entrance. And that can, I can make it a bit rounded as well. A rounded entrance. So what I'm trying to do here is I'm trying to make sort of a rounded kind of entrance here. I'm trying to have these as different corridors you can go down. I mean, the idea of a hobbit hole is, as you know, it's sort of built into the side of a hill and you've got like rounded windows, everything's very rounded, rounded doors, everything like that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to have some like tunnels. We want it to look tunnely. I mean, obviously I've built this out to be a complete square, but I want it to look like you're going through tunnels to try and find all of the things. I'm just creating all these rooms and I'm trying to sort of design it a bit like a tunnel that you're going through, a bit like it's been dug out rather than, well, than world edited out. Just want to get rid of that torch and place that inside. So yeah, I'm just trying to design all the rooms. For the time being, I'm not really putting much thought into it. I'm probably going to make a lot of changes to the walls and everything like that. But for the time being, I'm just digging out to roughly have all of the rooms sort of planned out before I start working on the interior. Just want to dig all of this out here, dig that out, replace it, and then that side. I just thought we've got another window the other side, don't we? That I haven't actually taken into consideration, that window there. So I'm just going to try and find that and make that into a room. It should be around about here. There it is. There we go. I just want to dig that out, place some wood in there, place it up there. I just want to replace all of this. Place that. Have the wall there and do the top. On the sides, build that up. And the last bit of wall. Fill it in. There we go. And then we can have a room in there. We can have something in here. Go through into here, into this room. And just close it off. And that's about it for the rooms. I think that's probably be enough. I have to replace all of that after. Cover all of that up. Actually, no, we've got something in here. This can be the main room, I think. Which I'm not too sure about the main room, but we'll do something here, I'm sure. And then we can have another room on connected onto it as well. So just trying to work out how we should look. Get rid of that. There we go. Get rid of that. And then we just create one last room here. This can be the bedroom. There we go, that will do. And this little snake round, got tunnels. Come into here. We need to build this room up. We haven't actually finished. We just want to have all the walls done before we start working on the interior. Place that. Build that up. Oh. There we go. Near the top. Build this up. Fill it all in. There we go. There we go. I'm changed my mind, I think, about the floor. I just want to change it over and change it into another block. So just find the other corner. No, I think it goes on a bit further. So we're just cheap by just digging into here. And fly over here. There we go. And then let's change the colour. What should I go for? Look at two. Yeah, that would go for that. We'll use birch. Just there's a bit of a contrast between the walls and the floor, so they don't look exactly the same. So I've just taken a short break and now I'm ready to do the interior, and I realise we need to try and make this look a bit more rounded. So I'm just going to replace all of these, and I'm going to place jungle wood instead in the place. I think it looks a bit more rounded now, and we'll just do the same on this side here and replace that. Place jungle wood at the top, and put that in there, and we'll just do the same on the corner here. There we go. At the top. There we go. And then we'll just put some wood in there. Get rid of that. Change the corner a bit. There we go, light that up. And then we can possibly put some bookshelves in all of the corners. This could be the entrance, so we probably want to put a table as well. Find where the fence... where is it? I'll just put some carpet, and then get the fence, and then just put the bookshelf in. Just put it in all the corners. And there we go. And just light it up. And then we can do some fences there. Something in the centre, and then just put some carpet. Oh, there we go. There we go, that worked. Okay, so this is sort of the entrance. We haven't really got too much. We don't really need too much, really. If you go into here, and we can possibly make this into maybe, what about a sort of kitchen area? So we'll just get a furnace, and then what else are we going to need? Well, let's use a piston to use work surfaces. I know it sounds a bit weird using a piston, but it looks alright. And then we'll use a crafting table and do some carpet. Let's just make the area. So put a piston down, and then we'll put a carpet on top. And then we'll have the workbench. What else can we put in here? Put another couple of pistons, and then make an even bigger work area, and that'll do. And then we need to do something here. How about we change these corners around a little bit and create this a bit more rounded? Actually, put that over that side. And then there we go. Looks a bit more rounded now, a bit more like a hobbit hole rather than before where it just looked like a square room. And there we go. We have to do something more, I think. We could do some bookshelves or put some in there. What else could we put in? What else? Maybe some tables, maybe. Put the torches there instead. We don't want them on the floor. Let's get some paintings. Let's get some flowers, maybe. Can you place flowers inside? No, clearly not. Actually, it might be because I'm planting it on wood. Let's try and get some grass and then change that over. Oh, there we go. That does work. Okay, that looks fairly nice. We'll do that then. And then let's get a frame. Maybe an anvil. I'm not too sure. Maybe some signs. Flower pot is going to be useful. And then a face. So item frame, I'll put at the top. Put head in there. And then it should put some paintings on the corners here. Put a painting there and there. Oh, you're trying to find the two. Actually, just use one. There we go. Actually, we need to make that into... We need to make that... Oh, for God's sake, we need to get rid of it. Oh, well. There we go, that looks a bit better. And then we'll put paintings on there and there. No, we don't want them the same, we'll change it around. There we go. We don't really have very good paintings on this texture pack. That's something we need to change around, put some more detailed paintings in, but for the time being, they'll do. And then let's put some tables in and put them on there. We can put a seating area. We have one on the other side. Opposite over. Should I use jungle? No, I've used jungle a lot. Let's just use just normal oak. Okay, that'll do. And then we can have table. Let's use different colour. Let's use pink. No problem in using pink. And place that on top. And there we go, we've got some tables. We can have something in here. I'm not really sure what we're going to do. Let's just make the room for the time being. Place that. Build it up. From there. And then... that's the wrong way. Place it. In there. Like so. And then we do the other side. And then the corner bit. There we go. What can this room be? Just put some lights in. I'm not too sure what we can do in this room. What do you guys think? Maybe a bedroom in there? I'm thinking bedrooms in these rooms, and that room there, and then the main room down here. What should we use that room for? Maybe I could come back to that room, do something after. Let's work on this bit here. This is going to be awkward because it's in such a weird angle. So let's just place some jungle wood down and try and design how we can have this. That's going to have to do. And then maybe we can put a bed in. Could extend it out, but I'm not too sure. I think that's fine. I think we should try and utilise the space that we have available to us. So let's just try and find a bed and just place the bed down. And we can put a couple of chests maybe, a painting. That'll probably be enough. We don't really need too much. This is just a spare room. I'll put chests there. And then flower pot. No, that can't go. Put the painting on top. Maybe just name it. Just name it guest room. Room. There we go. That'll probably do. That's probably enough. And then a painting. That'll do. That'll do. That's fair. That's good enough. We don't really need too much. That's probably enough. And then we can go on to the master room, master bedroom. We can place them in there and then just design that. And we can go there, can go there, that can go there. Just thought about this room. We haven't actually done anything in this room. Oh, what can we do? Maybe this can be some sort of reading area, maybe? We can put some books in. I'll just fill that in. And then maybe we can have this as some sort of seating area. No, we can't get rid of that. Maybe the jungle can go there instead. And then we could have some seats. What can we do for it? Let's just use normal oak wood and get rid of those. Just do that. And then... we just put some bookshelves here. Just have that built into the wall for the bookshelf. And then have that rounded again. What else can we do? Maybe we can have a table in. Just use a table there. Oh no, put a bit closer. And I just got rid of it because I'm an idiot. And then we just want some carpet on top. Use red. Some red carpet. And that'll do. That's good enough. And then the master bedroom. What can we do for the master bedroom? We can basically get rid of that and replace that, put that on top and back, and then just place bed in there, and then let's just get that, just use that to put that at the top, and then light it up. What else can we do? Let's get rid of that and let's put some grass in, and we can have a flower on top. Maybe some, oh, we need some glass. We haven't actually put any glass in for the window pane, so let's find some glass and let's get a flower pot and a orange tulip, and then we can go glass, flower pot, orange tulip, and then we can use the trapdoor on that to some sort of shutter. What else? We need something here. What can we do? Put a couple chests, and maybe we can just make that into a desk. So we just get another couple fences, some seats, so we just use this, and then we'll just put some carpet, and let's use black. Okay, and that's the final bit of carpet. There we go, and let's put some signs for the corner of the chair. Use sign, and then, oh, I don't want to write on it, oops. Get rid of that, and then the other side, there we go. And that's fairly complete, pretty much done. So let's go back onto the outside and let's work on the garden a little bit more. We need to change this around a bit more. I think we need a bit more of an overgrowth because I don't think that's good enough at the moment. It looks a bit bland, it looks a bit boring. So just place some of these over here. This can extend up a little bit. And then that can go up a bit higher here. What else? Okay, I've decided we're going to make a quick tree. So we're just going to fly over to this one here. Just make sure we're using the right leaves. Yep, we are. And then we'll just grab some oak. And then we'll just do a quick tree. Now, I don't pretend to be particularly great at designing trees. But I'm just going to give it a go. Because why not? Just make a real basic tree. Nothing special. We're not going to make it particularly big. Just want something, I don't know, that'll do for the branches, and then we'll just work on the leaves. Just go around, just placing a few leaves to make, just go around like that, place that down there, down there, place that up here, and just design that, come over to the side, just place a few more leaves, keep going around, a couple more leaves. I don't really know what I'm doing with making a tree, to be honest, but just giving it a go. Probably could have used one of the template trees if I wanted to, but for tutorial purposes, I'm just making my own one. Fly around, just build that up a little bit, and then we'll just do something at the top. Let's have a quick look how it's gonna look. Actually, it seems a bit short. We just want that to go up a bit higher, I think. Just build up a bit more. It seems a bit too small, to be honest. Okay, so just keep going, keep placing a few more leaves. Just place it round, just make it try to look natural as possible. And to be honest, that'll do, to be honest. I think that's just about done. Just build the side up a little bit. Yeah, and it should put some bone meal. Just bone meal it up. Just cover with bone meal, place it round. And there we go. Actually, no, we just want to place a few more leaves here. I'm not really too happy with this. We just have that going round, just a few more leaves on this side. As at the moment, I think it looks a bit naff, to be honest. There we go. That's okay. I'm fairly happy with that. And that's another hobbit hole made for our brie.